definitely got to celebrate them. And I just was feeling good. It's nice sometimes being outside. Like, I think I was on lane 7. Sometimes it's nice being like out of the pack a little bit. So you literally don't know what's going on, so you're just focused on yourself. Fresh track's pretty easy to do that because I can't see people around me except on turns. So it's just nice to be able to focus on your own race, do, you know, put together what you're supposed to do. This morning felt good, but I was long into every single turn, long/lazy. So tonight I was like, don't be lazy into the turns. So try to just maintain a good rhythm, and then 3 fast strokes into the wall, and it just sets me up well for the safety.
How was your success in the 100 transition into the 200 recently?
Yeah, it's weird. They're like so different that I don't know how to answer the question. I think that the 100 is a little bit trickier, to be honest, because your technique has to be so good.
When in time, the lead model breaks along at 7:57:49.
Like, my technique has to hold up with the fast track mode, and I think that's actually a little bit harder to do and have a smoother, more efficient stroke. So sometimes I like the 200 better. I think it's a little bit easier to wrap your brain around. And I mean, the 100, I think it's easier to sort of pick it up from the 200 than to go the other way around. So I like doing the 200 first.
Does that give you a good bit of confidence knowing that the trials are less than 2 months now?
Yeah, I think so. Obviously, have never really put a ton of focus or emphasis on the 200. Obviously, it's changing, so I'm excited. 200's first at trials, so that's good. Unlike Olympic trials, which was not so great. It'll be really good, obviously, set up for the 100, but definitely focusing on that now as a main event and to the finals.
Nice.